November 21st meeting of the Pembroke Board of Selectmen. We'll begin our meeting with the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please note that this meeting is being made available to the public through a live video and audio broadcast on Comcast Government Access Channel 15, and is being recorded for broadcast at future dates. Comments made in open session will be recorded. And this evening, our first appointment is with Kathleen Keegan. She wants to speak to the board about the Christmas tree lighting program. Kathleen, would you like to come up front?
Sure. Greetings, honorable Board of Selectmen and Town Administrator. I'm Kathleen Keegan. I'm the chairperson for the Pembroke Tree Lighting, which is a wonderful holiday community event that my committee puts on every year. And you know, before you have a list of all the things that are happening on the tree lighting, some of which are the military support group is going to place ribbons on the veterans tree for deployed soldiers. We have roasting marshmallows over fire pits, cookie decorating, padding holiday rabbits, tractor and range car rides going around the community center. We have a live nativity, luminaries, touch a truck, kids games, photo booth. The librarian's going to be doing story time. We have frozen holiday characters walking around. And this year, some of our new items, which we're really excited about, we have a theater group, which is going to be doing The Grinch Who Stole Christmas. They're going to do the reading and then the songs as well. We have a pony ride. AMP 103 Radio is also going to be there giving doing games, Plinko, and a beanbag toss, and both giving out prizes as well. And then the Boy Scouts will be doing a ceremony with a peace candle. And then, of course, the finale at 5 o'clock, and Santa comes roaring in on a fire truck. And we'll throw the magical switch and light all the trees along the green. So, of course, as we try to do every year, all these activities are free for Pembroke residents, so that way they can create a warm, wonderful memory for their family at no cost to them. But there is a cost to it for us. If you flip over on the other side of it, it does show you some of the items that cost us money. We do try to get as many things donated as much as possible. But still, in the end, we're looking at just under $4,000 to try to put this event on. And I would like to humbly request $2,700 from the town to help put on the event, and then we'll raise the rest of it.
Thank you, Kathleen. Also, in the information we have is that the DPW is reporting that they will need an additional $200 to replace some lights that will go on the trees.
Sure.
So that is in addition to the $2,700 that you are requesting.
Correct.
Is that correct? Any board members have any questions for Kathleen?
That's a great event.
It is a great event, and I think you and your group are doing a wonderful job, and this is quite an expansion from what we've done in the past.
Right, yeah, each year we always try to bring on a few more new things.
Now, can I ask Mr. Bond, we have a new fund that we have created, taking money left over from the 300. There were attachments to how that money could be spent, and I know we have the Camp Pembroke Fund as well.
Right.
Would there be either one would be appropriate here?
Sabrina, I don't think that that article that created that fund, was that subject to the approval of the Attorney General?
Yes. We're still waiting for the Attorney General.
So, you're just limited to the Camp Pembroke Fund at this point.
Okay.
We have $3,000 in the committee.
Yes.
Yep. So, we would need $2,700 for Kathleen's committee and $200 that the DPW would like to get to replace some lights. So that would be $2,900. Is there a motion from the board?
I'll
We give $3,000 out of the camera fund.
Motion by Bill.
Second.
Second by Arthur. Dan?
Just a point of information for everyone. Whenever this board taps into the Camp Pembroke Fund, I receive messages wondering why we're stealing money from the Camp Pembroke Fund. It must be a great organization. Well, the reality is the Camp Pembroke Fund is a payment in lieu of taxes. So rather than pay taxes, they pay into a fund. So we're not taking from any camp. So I just want the folks to know that.
But that's a good point, Dan. And they have, that's why that fund has been created, and we have a great relationship with Camp Pembroke. So I have a motion and a second. Are there any other questions? Hearing none, all in favor of Bill's motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, deem that to be unanimous.
Yes. Well, thank you.
Well, thank you, Kathleen, yeah. And I hope things go as well as you've been planning them.
Well, thank you. Yeah, so mark your calendars for Sunday, December 4th. It's in 2 weeks from 2 to 5. And like us on Facebook, the Pembroke Tree Lighting. There's also pembroketreelighting.com. So,
okay.
Love to see
this one,
there.
Right. Do we have a rain date?
We've never had a rain date. We've never had a need for a rain date.
Doesn't mean we have to work on
magic. Say again?
Don't jinx us, Bill.
It means we have to work on magic.
Yeah. You know what? Like I said, we've never had one, but now that you've just said that, maybe, maybe we need to figure out something.
Yeah.
It snowed before, which is wonderful.
We worked all our magic in the past year on the 300th, and every one of those events went off good.
That's true, yeah.
We had a 72-degree day in February, as I recall.
Oh. Well, again, thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Thanks
and so
for coming
so
in
do your residents.
Our next item for consideration is Police Chief Richard Wall, who wants to address the board on the issue of ballot question number 4.
Good evening.
Good evening, Jim.
First off, I'd like to thank the voters that came out in the town of Pembroke, and the voters, along with the Board of Selectmen, the school committee, and Pembroke Heights Against Drugs, the Board of Health, and the Police Department, were in opposition to ballot question 4. So what I'm asking the Board of Selectmen tonight is just to explore the local options set up in the ballot initiative before we make any decisions on what we plan to do with that. And I've already looked into that, and I've had different opinions from a lot of different people. I've heard that they're not really solid, and it's in like control we will have.
Chief, isn't there a provision that if the town voted against it, that you can limit or deny a retail spot for them? I mean, medical marijuana is a different story,
right,
entirely.
So there is Section 3 is the local control option, and I think the town just needs to explore what options we do have before we go ahead and commit to their own establishments. I'd rather have the discussion now before somebody comes in and they argue for proof. So that's all I'm asking the town to commit to that. The voters didn't approve of the ballot, but it's in the best interest of the voters.
Can I ask, do we know if there's a specific action this board needs to take to fall within the parameters of the law?
There's a petition, one of the things to and again, I'm still waiting for guidance from town council and waiting for guidance from the Mass Chiefs Council and from probably the AG's office on where this is going to go. There's a lot of questions that I'm just sharing in the ledger about other police departments going through the same issues. So all I'm asking is that we don't take any actions other than sort of what we should be doing or what we could be doing for the next time.
Should we be exploring a zoning article, or do we have one place that would encompass retail marijuana, because we have it for adult bookstores and that kind of thing?
No overlay zone.
Yeah, exactly.
I think there in the initiative, which is 27 pages long, it's not just...
That's what they call it, brief.
There are things about having recreational and safety areas as an article and such. Again, I'm not, I've read it a few times and I'm not fully versed on it. I don't think it's exactly, I can't be sound at this point. So I'm just asking that the board take whatever actions you have to look into that. We can sit down and have more discussions about it before we start issuing permits.
Yeah, I think the terms and conditions that were attached to Article 4 that we voted on were all written by the industry, and they had no input from the state legislature. So now that that had passed, now I understand that the legislature is looking at this very closely. And our treasurer, Deborah Goldberg, is responsible for setting up a marijuana commission who will have different rules and regulations. And they have not done that yet, but they are looking at it. So as everybody is researching this and trying to find out what we should do and what we can do, and I think it's great that we have you on top of this tree.
I'll keep on it. And any news that we can share together to figure out what's best interest for the town. This is,
As you had told me earlier, from the chiefs of Hanover and Lashfield, both of those towns have rejected question four. So I know that their chiefs of those two towns would probably be talking to you about this very issue, because everyone has got the same questions and has to find the right answers.
So I'm not sure what it requires a board to do, whether to take a vote to explore this proposal in front of you. I'm not sure how that works, but I just wanted to get it out there. And
so if I could offer something, Mr. Chairman, I think if this board wants to take the chief's advice and act on looking at the local options, I think we should do something that will put a time stamp on it. I think this board should make a motion and a vote to explore local control options and establish a committee to look into those local control options. And a small committee, town administrator, police chief, and one board of selectmen, so that we not only have taken a vote, but we've taken an active participation into looking at these options. So that if from the ACLU says, nope, you didn't act enough, at least we'll have done two things, a vote and formed a committee. I don't know what else we can do on that one. We don't know.
Well, you and I think alike on that issue. I talked to the chief about that very thing. I think it's a good idea. Bill, would you know?
I just think that we should not have a small committee talking about this. We should add in the other people that should be more helped. It should be another and the other one. I think that some people can. They would be able to give us insight into.
Boards to include, certainly.
Any other discussion?
No, I think we're on the right track.
So, Dan, that was your idea. Would you like to make a motion?
I make a motion that the Board of Selectmen officially explore the local control options that the town of Pembroke has in regards to ballot question four.
Second. Good. Motion by Dan and second by Bill. Any other comments or questions? Hearing none, all those in favor of Dan's motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, I deem it unanimous.
Mr. Chairman, make a motion to allow it.
Certainly.
That this board create a subcommittee to look into these local options, and subcommittee should include, at a minimum, the police chief, the town administrator, a member of the board of selectmen, a member of the board of health, and a member of the planning board.
Second.
Second by Appa. Any other comments? I think that's a good additional motion, and we could state that that's where the members should come from, and we have a chance to talk to the planning board and the board of health and explain it to them, and I'm sure that they would give us the name of a member. So all in favor of Dan's motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None, I deem that to be unanimous as well. Good, chief, thank you very much for coming in. And keep in touch. The next item on the agenda is the consideration to appoint Eric Hurt of West Street to a vacancy on the Recreation Commission. We have an email here from Susan Roach, who is supporting Mr. Hurt. Are you Mr. Hurt?
I am.
Good, thank you for coming in. We have the information in front of us that you not only are interested in it, but the Recreation Commission would like you to be on their board.
And he's a prank.
Oh, he is, okay. Do I have any questions, or do I have a motion?
Move the appointment of Eric Hurt to the Recreation Commission.
Good, motion by Arthur and a second by Bill. Any other questions? Hearing none, all those in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Hearing none, I deem that to be unanimous. Now, you need to get sworn in, and at that swearing in, they would get a handbook.
He gets a letter.
Which will give you all the information that you need.
Thanks a lot.
To be a member and what some of the rules are. So thank you very much for volunteering, and we look forward to having you on Recreation.
Thank you very much.
On board. The next item on our agenda is a review of the Hill Park project, site number 2. Now, the board may remember that the Hill Park restoration project on Valley Street started in 2010, and it consists of 4 different phases. Phase 1, I understand, has been completed, and phase 2 was approved by this board as far as the conditions of truck traffic and times that they would be on the road. And that has been going on. Now, the owner, Jeffrey Bias, he had agreed to keep the board posted on his progress. And at a meeting we had requested a 6-month visit with the board just to update us on what is going on. Now, the last couple of years of this, the people that live on Valley Street have contacted me and maybe other members of the board, I'm not sure, or the town administrator, but they're very concerned about the amount of trucks that are on Valley Street. Now, when we approved the different phases of this, we have discussed how many trucks, and so we are controlling that. And when trucks leave the bog on Valley Street, they are to turn right and go all the way down Valley to Route 53 in Kingston, and then they would go wherever they're going. But they are not to go left on Valley Street. and I understand that's pretty much being followed. Now, unfortunately, Mr. Mathis passed away in a terrible accident in 2015. And Mrs. Mathias has called our office, and she would like to continue the project. And she's going to be working with PA Landers, who would do the trucking. So I just think where we have not been updated on what's going on, and unfortunately with the death of Mr. Mathias, I would like to recommend that we ask Mrs. Mathias to come in and update the board on what the plans are, and maybe more importantly, what is the time frame on this project? It has four phases, and I believe only one phase has been completed, but she can give us all that information. Now, the residents of Valley Street would like to know how long they're going to put up with the truck traffic. And there's even some speeding issues and so forth that I had worked with the police chief on that. But, so we got a couple of issues here. Where is this project? What is an expected timetable? And keeping in mind the residents of Valley Street who have been really put upon by all the trucks. But this is an agricultural site, and the town really has very little authority over what goes on there. He's trying to restore the cranberry bogs there. And in order to do that, to supply the amount of water that is necessary to run a cranberry business, he is dredging out a couple of the small ponds that are on that site. I think it's 13 acres of land. And that requires a great deal of gravel removal. He's looking for ponds to be about 10 feet deep. And one, as I said, has been completed, and they are starting on a second one. So if the board would agree with my assessment on this, I would like to start by inviting Mrs. Mathias to come before us and give us an update of the project, and included in that update some time frame so that this board and the residents of Valley Street will get an idea of what's going on and how much longer this is going to take. So you have some information that is in your packet. Does anybody have any questions that they would like to raise or comments they would like to make? Time frame we could address some issues that we received.
Yeah, it's been an ongoing project, so I think it's a good idea for the property owner to come for us and give us an update. I just want the property owner to know and understand. If they don't, then maybe they've been out of touch and bubble, just have no knowledge of the residents' concerns. So even if they paraphrased by the Boulter Ed to the property owner, so they know what this is all about.
Well, when we contact Mrs. Mathias about coming in and we settle on a convenient date for her to be here, we'll get her on the agenda as soon as possible. And on our agenda is always posted. And anyone that lives on Valley Street or any other street that has an interest in this project could certainly see when the meeting is going to be. They could attend, and they have a chance to ask any questions.
I think that's very important. Mr. Mathias came forward to the Selectmen originally, and he started this project. He was under the understanding of the board also, but you mentioned earlier that this is a project that has to do with restoration of cranberries and all that. It falls under different jurisdictions, and really doesn't give the Selectmen a lot of authority to mandate things that they do. So he worked very well with us in regards to concerns over the property owners. Back then, when he first started the project, by saying that the trucks would be early, they were late, they were trying to stagger the vehicles, that's a bus traffic, all that kind of stuff. So he listened to all our concerns, even though we didn't have to. We would have a problem going forward if it was the same. There's a way to agree to it with this guy who made the name. So, hopefully, she would be upset.
Well, I would agree with you, Bill. That's normally an earth removal project, such as maybe a housing development, that would come before this board. And we could set rules and regulations on the removal of that earth and days and times and so forth. This particular case, you are right, we do not have that authority. However, the property owner, when he appeared before us, we brought up those issues that we would normally bring up if we had the authority, and he agreed to them all. And he was very, very cooperative. And I'm looking for that same point of view again. And so we'll set that up. We had a motion on that, I'm sorry. All in favor of setting up a meeting to discuss the Mathias property? Please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Hearing none? And deem that to be unanimous.
And just a comment on it.
Yes, sir.
The agricultural exemptions that are enjoyed by the bloggers can't outweigh the safety of the public. We're not rural Pembroke of 4,000 people anymore. We've got 20,000 people, a lot of whom are kids. And we need to pay particular attention to that, I think.
I think you're right. Exactly. Next item of business is to a vote of the board to add a street light to the town's inventory on Center Street pole number 58, which is in the immediate area of the Arrow restaurant on Center Street. Police Chief Wall has performed a public safety assessment of the area, and he has determined that the town needs to reactivate a light on pole number 58. which is across from the Arrow Restaurant.
I would move the chief's recommendation.
Motion by Arthur and a second by Bill. Any questions? Hearing none, all those in favor of the motion, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, hearing none, I deem that to be unanimous. Under old business, does anyone have any issues? I have one. On August 9, 2016, Governor Baker signed an act to modernize mutual finance and government. And what that means is that the Board of Selectmen may designate any one of its members for the purpose of approving bills or payrolls. And that member, after making the approvals, must make a statement to the board of what actions were taken. So a record of the actions of the board's designee, which was myself, on November 15, 2016, I personally reviewed 6 accounts payable warrants totaling $96,092.51 and 2 payroll warrants totaling $1,213,337.91, which were prepared by the town accountant and authorized the itemized expenditures for payment. And I have signed this statement, and I'd like a vote to accept that.
Move to accept.
Motion by Arthur, second by Bill. Any questions? All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, hearing none, deem that to be unanimous. The town administrator's report, please.
A couple of items, Mr. Chairman. One thing I didn't mention while we had Ms. Keegan here is that I've been requested by the building department to ensure that all of the operations of the Christmas tree lighting are contingent upon the approval of the electrical inspector with all of the lighting and the generators and everything that are there, that has been requested. So I would say state that in the letter that we sent to Ms. Keegan that you would want the approval of the electrical inspector, wire inspector, to ensure the safety of everybody that's going to be in attendance.
Very important.
Definitely don't have some wires out there somewhere. Somebody gets to that.
Number two, I've been requested by a couple of folks here in town to see if the town would be interested in auctioning off some surplus property that would be in adjacent to their properties that they have right now, and I told them that I would bring it to the board's attention on Monday the 28th, so an agenda item for the board to consider. But I wanted to give the board a heads up on that's going to be coming your way on Monday. I will be discussing that a future surplus property auction.
They do know that this is going to be a public auction. We can't just sell to one person.
Right, exactly. Absolutely. I made that clear on more than one occasion.
I know you did. I wanted to make sure we set it here.
Public. Set the minimum bid as well.
Okay. Well, that'll be on next Monday's agenda. Number three, you've got a survey, and I apologize for the lateness of the request, but I've been had a meeting with several department heads today about Friday after Thanksgiving, and as you can see from the survey that I did in 2012 and as recently as this afternoon, and nothing's changed for the communities on the South Shore. Having the Friday after Thanksgiving. The reason that's become an issue is that, of the almost 30 people that work in Town Hall, over 21 or so will be off according to union contracts. And so, in fact, the entire first floor will be manned by
in personnel. So, you know, basically, we'll have between 4 to 5, maybe 6, if everybody shows up on Friday, named Town Hall. And I'm requesting that the board consider having Town Hall closed Friday after Thanksgiving. As you can see, it's pretty much unanimous on the South Shore as far as that holiday is concerned.
Jim, I would just do a motion that we accept the town administrator's request to have the town employees on the day after Thanksgiving.
Motion by Bill, is there a second?
I second that, I have a question for Ed.
Certainly.
Is there a reason you think it's been open for a number of years?
It's been, well, ever since it's been incorporated into the clerical union contract, it's been maintained by 3 to 4 people on a Friday. You know, and I think it, and Sabrina will attest to this, that, you know, when people come in, I think that they'd be more upset if they walked into the building and couldn't find certain offices open, as opposed to coming in, coming to the front door and seeing it, oh, well, it's closed today. And that being said, because, you know, it's kind of awkward for the folks that are working, and there's only one person in each office, and that would be the department head, because they're the only ones that would be exempt from the clerical union. So it's been something we contemplated, and some department heads came to me today, and, you know, and I apologize for the latency, but I would have preferred that this discussion been held last Monday, but, you know, quote our famous football coach, just happened the way it is.
I'm keeping in tune with every other town that's in this whole area. Like 22 different towns that are all closed again.
Matthew, your second, you had a question, you all set?
Yeah, I think I'm going to
I have concern as well, and involved the firefighters contract, that the town hall be closed, and I understand it's in conjunction with the DPW being closed at the same time, and that won't be the case on Friday, the DPW will be open. But it would otherwise trigger an overtime for the firefighters contract. Not to say that the firefighters making money, but, you know, to spend the taxpayer money.
Yeah, well, I think when you make a decision, you should go on. All we need is a certain type of decision. I would agree with you that it costs a lot of money. It's not the case here. So it's a good point. My only concern is the fact that we're just discussing this tonight, and I know Ed didn't know anything until this afternoon about this request, but it doesn't give us a lot of time to notify the public. We should vote to close Friday, but other than that, I don't have an issue.
This is only for this year. So next year, I would expect, anticipating something, a question coming up well in advance, so that we can discuss it and have time to get our thoughts together and get some input from the public. So,
well, I agree.
This is a one-time deal. Getting up 5 o'clock in the morning and going to work Friday after Thanksgiving, so
I'm working at
Dan, would you think that we could put an amendment on Bill's motion if he would agree that it would only be for single meal? Do you think that's...
I don't know if we need a motion. That was the motion, wasn't it, for this Friday?
Oh, it was. I'm sorry. Thank you. Yeah, I lost track of that. Okay, so we have a motion, a second, and a discussion. If there's no other questions or issues, all in favor of the motion to close Friday, the day after Thanksgiving, for this year, please say aye. Aye. Opposed? Hearing none, I deem that as unanimous. Ask the selectmen, does anyone have an issue under this section? Bill?
Kind of feel bad about it in a way, but not. But I've actually talked to the police chief. The DPW blocked off the public way down off of Ridge Avenue some time ago, and they reopened it because I made a stink about it. Blocking the public way, and it was the reason that they did that was because so many people dumping and trash and all that in the woods down there. Since then, I've had a conversation with the director of the DPW on that, that they could have improved the road down there so that more people would travel it, and there would probably be less chance of people dumping if it was better traveled. Anyway, the DPW went down there and cleaned up all of the trash and picked everything all up and made it squeaky clean. And lo and behold, somebody didn't go right back down there again and dump a whole truckload of trash in the same area down there with appliances and all that and put it into the area. So I've talked to the police chief about it and asked if he could get a hold of one of the police chiefs that's retired now in the Mass Chiefs that actually has his camera set up and you can view them online. So I did have some discussion with him. He's going to look into it. He's going to get back to me, and I will address the board with it in the future. I think we should support the chief, not only there, but there could be several other places. Would be some places that are of interest to the chief that he would want the camera to monitor, something that may be taking place. And so it's something that we would like to look at in the future. There's no way you're going to be able to put a police officer down in the woods every single night after night. You can't afford that. So there's other options to look at. We're going to try to do that, get that done so that we can catch the people that are doing this. It's not right to just dump your trash any way you want. One of the other concerns that I had was they were dumping their trash on the Pembroke property in the stream that goes through Silver Lake. And that's widely open and available for a vehicle to back in and dump whatever they want to do into that stream off of Center Street, which they have done. They would clean that up a number of times. They recently have dumped the boy trash in there. That would be a bad location to be putting anything into the stream down there because it would go directly to Silver Lake. I've talked to Silver Lake about it to some extent. I think we even sent a letter to them a while ago about maybe putting up some type of a gate down there that would allow so many people to park there out near the road, and then also get a key in Rockland so that they can get into the building. But that's another area that we should protect because it goes to a water source, and we definitely don't want people dumping things at the water source or Silver Lake in the middle of the night. We don't know if they're going to dump it, so there should be some security there. As long as the board doesn't have a problem with that, I'll work with the chief on it.
I think that's a great idea, and I'm glad you're willing to do that. People that live in Pembroke, all you have to have is a dump sticker, and on Saturday between 9 and 3, you can get the recycling center, and they have all the facilities there to take whatever you have. If you're not a resident of the town of Pembroke, then you're not allowed to go there. And with curbside pickup, you can arrange to have things picked up on a particular day just by calling the company. So this is something that should be avoided. But I think your idea is a good one. Any other issues under Ask the Selectmen? New business, anyone have anything they want to bring up?
I think given an incident that took place in the last week or 10 days, we need to see if we have, and if we don't, we need to develop a protocol for elected officials arriving at the scene of an accident or whatever you want to call it, and trying to get involved in the policing the incident. The police don't need extra help from people who are unqualified to give it, and there's no power in a board of one, and I just think that we have at least one public official who is not aware of the protocol for being, it would be like one of us directing traffic because we are police commissioners. I mean, it's just something that isn't done. And I think that we need to set a policy about it so that people understand when they arrive at an accident or a fire or whatever, that they're there as private citizens and they're not there to assist in the operation. That can only get us in trouble.
I'm sorry, Chief Wall.
While you're on that subject, Selectman Boyle, I have a letter I'm going to send out to my ship commanders and to the officers in charge. You want to read it to you real quick?
Certainly, go right ahead.
I'm going to send it out to them tomorrow after I talk to you tonight. From time to time, the Pembroke Police will respond to incidents or events that require calling and resources from other agencies beyond the members of our own department, in our fire department first responders. We have always maintained a good working relationship with our town's full-time agents in all the inspectional services and value their professional service and willingness to help. This letter is not in reference to the agents who we call for service. Ship commanders and officers must understand that they are responsible for the integrity of any crime or accident scene that we are dispatched to until otherwise relieved, and thereby we're responsible for the safety of those persons that are allowed to access. There may be circumstances where other police officers, elected officials, civilians, or even the press will self-deploy and request access to the scene. It is the ship commander or officer in charge's decision to allow or not allow access to the scene based on the totality of the circumstances. Very simple.
That's perfect.
So, I'm instructing my officers. It's up to the ship commanders whether or not they don't allow somebody. It depends on the scene. We'll just go with that.
Yeah. Well, I think that certainly makes very good sense. We have a lot of very interested citizens and people that serve on boards, including this board.
Right.
But if you go to a scene, happen to be driving by, and an accident or anything, if there's a police officer there, they're going to handle it.
And again,
we are not equipped to do it.
If you're there, and we need your help, we'll ask you. We'll bring you on board. It's not an issue.
All right. We agree with that letter. Thank you, Chief.
Thank you.
Back to new business. I would like to report to the board that I attempted to represent the town at the Plymouth County Advisory Board meeting on November 17th. And just to give the board a highlight of what took place there, they had a gentleman who put on a program, a tick awareness program. which is a very serious issue on the South Shore and on the Cape. And he's going to be providing his expertise to the Plymouth County Commissioners. And they're going to be setting up a program where information will be made available to the public on what to do about infant tick issues that we have. Another highlight of the meeting was that the commissioners have completed the final three audits of years that were not done. And they concluded years 2013, 14, 15, all the back years have now been completed. I guess that was a very big problem for the commissioners when they were elected. That had not been done. They also established a stabilization fund for the first time, and they deposited $300,000 into that fund. They also voted some budget transfers for items that were under budgeted, or they had a cost that wasn't anticipated, and also for dredging equipment, which they have purchased, and towns could be using this dredging equipment. So that was kind of a snapshot of what happened at the Plymouth County Advisory Board meeting.
We have Mr. Chairman, Pembroke Fisheries has requested to use their dredging equipment on certain areas of Pembroke. It would be beneficial for Heron Fisheries to get the Heron up and down through some of the places that are pretty clogged up. So it's a matter of putting a plan together and getting the proper permits and all that to do all that. So it's a good possibility that we may use some of that equipment here.
That'd be great.
Any other note that I just had? That, I don't know if I mentioned it last week or not, but I believe that in checking all of the places that we do check normally every day or the other day, we haven't found any juvenile fish that are still passing from Molden Pond out to the North River. So I think that they're pretty much all gone for the winter. We're really hoping so. We've closed the gate to the dam down on the backside of Furlong Pond, and so the pond has come up a couple of inches in the last week. So I'm kind of hoping that we get another 2 feet or 2.5 feet of water in the pond, so we could use the ladders to get them up in the spring, which is going to be a chore to get enough water for that. So we're on top of that, and if that doesn't work, then we can figure out something in another way. I know in the past some of the other boards have actually hand netted fish and brought them up. Put them in trucks or whatever and netted them and brought them up. So hopefully we don't have to do that. But there was quite a crew of fish, the juvenile fish that went down this year. Most fish that I've ever seen in my lifetime. Almost like back in the old days. Millions of juvenile fish going down this year. I'm pretty happy about that.
Okay, good. And I think that's a tribute to our fisheries folks that work with you, Bill, and our superintendent's planning and the cooperation from a lot of people, I think, have worked very hard to keep the waters clear and free.
Just one other thing I'd like to say while I've been a little bit of access to the public. We spent several weeks cleaning the streams and clearing brush and shrubs and all kinds of other things from the streams, and trailer loads of shopping carts and other things that people throw into the streams, and we've cleaned all of that out. And what seems to be a really big problem in some areas is people blowing their leaves into the pond or into the streams. And that clogs up the stream so that the fish, especially the juvenile fish, can't get through. And they actually stopped and talked to a person last week that was blowing everything from the street in his yard into one particular stream, and he was very cooperative. Didn't understand that was a problem, and said that it wouldn't happen again in the future. So we corrected that. But all of the people out there that live along the stream, it's very important that you keep an eye on the stream and don't throw things in the stream. And if you do see anybody doing that, if you could just call the Selectmen's office and let us know, we'll get on and talk to those people and try to get it straightened out, because it's important to get the fish up and back down again, so that we can bring Pembroke back to where it used to be years ago. We're not going to do that by ourselves, so we need help from everybody for that. So.
Very good. Thank you, Bill. Upcoming issues for the board. On November 28th at 7 p.m., we will have a public hearing, and the Board of Assessors will be discussing the fiscal year 17 tax classification hearing. And also on November 28th at 7:30, the Pembroke British Beer Company will appear before us with a change of manager request. And on December 12th, this board will vote the annual liquor license renewals. And if I can ask Sabrina, do we have a date for the planning board's public hearing on the solar farm?
No, I was just going to mention that. That's also November 28th. Here in the Veterans Hall, the planning board is conducting a mandatory public hearing on the solar farm project.
So we hope anyone who is interested in the solar farm project that will be on the landfill on Bob Block Street at 7:30 on the 28th. In VFW Hall, Veterans Hall, I'm sorry. Veterans Hall, they will have public hearing and give all the information necessary. And we have a need for executive session, Mr. Fong.
Yes, sir.
And I have a motion, please.
Mr. Chairman, we'll go to executive session.
And the chair so declares. Is there a second to Bill's motion?
Second.
Second by Matt. All in favor of it, they will go with a voice vote. Dan?
Yes.
Matthew?
Yes.
Bill?
Yes.
Arthur?
Yes.
And I vote yes. We will not be coming back into public session or taking any votes after the executive session. And the next regularly scheduled meeting of the Board of Selectmen will be Monday, November 28th at 7 p.m. Happy and a safe Thanksgiving to everyone, and we'll see you next week.